Yeah, so I mean, you're a Miami guy, Monsignor Pace High. First, what are your memories of the last time you played football in South Florida as a high school football player?
Yeah, that was the last time I played football there. My last senior night game against Belen Jesuit, obviously team rival, school rival, was able to get a win. Kind of like I said, the last time I played football down there, I didn't get a chance to play there in college, and then in the NFL, I think I've had a couple opportunities, but was either hurt or didn't play that game. So I've played against Miami, but haven't played in Miami. So first time. My family will be able to, have so much, closeness to me, for practice and games and stuff like that. So it'll be a cool opportunity. I'm looking forward to
Were you a Dolphins fan growing up?
it. No, I was not. I'm not going to tell you. I was not. Weird. My dad grew up and, was in love with the Dallas Cowboys, and he told me I had to become a fan or I couldn't live in his house. So I became a fan really quickly.
You got to live in his house, so
No doubt,
understand.
no doubt.
Thanks.
Mark?
Hey Anthony, it's Mark Stahl with the Miami Times. Welcome back.
Appreciate you, my guy. How you doing?
Doing well. Just quick question as far as you joining the team, how do you feel your impact will make immediate impact? You are a captain on the Cleveland Browns, and you bring some leadership coming down to South Florida with you. So how do you feel like your impact will transform this defense?
Yeah, I mean, for me, just being myself every day, being the same guy every day, intentional about my work, intentional about the details, and I just do that every day. And how that feeds off on others and everything like that, only time will tell, right? But I think me coming in and not doing anything outside of my norm, just being the same guy every day, showing up every day, priding myself on being the same person, being the same teammate. And letting the work take care of itself, and however that chips fall after that, we can't predict, but all I can control is what I do every day and me showing up every day, and I take pride in that.
All right, and if I can follow up, was your decision hard to join the Dolphins, or was it just mostly just having the opportunity to come back home?
It wasn't hard at all. I stressed to my agent very, 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 very important to get me out the cold. I was sick of it. I hadn't been home in a while. I was in the Midwest for since I was 17 years old. So I was like, it's about time I, get some warm weather. And he said Miami, and I was like, whatever, let's go, let's get it done. So obviously, being home and all that stuff is great and everything like that. But an opportunity to just continue to play this game at the highest level is something that I'll always cherish.
Joe?
Hey Anthony, it's Joe Shad from the Palm Beach Post. It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
Fill us in on the knee injury. What was the injury, and how far back are you now?
Yeah, so basically, in September 2022, the Thursday night game against the Steelers, I tore my quad tendon. Missed the rest of the season that year. And then came back last year. What was that, week 12, 13? Wasn't anything significant. I didn't think it was, or the team didn't think it was. We thought, just soreness, whatever. Ended up being a low-grade infection or something inside the knee. So basically, obviously no structural damage, but more so just have to clean it out, antibiotics and all that stuff. And like I said, I don't know how it came. They don't know how it came. It could be anything from the first time I had surgery to, anything, but obviously it was all negative. All my tests were negative and everything like that. So just follow the protocol with the antibiotics and the rehab. And I'm back full go now, training and everything. So I'll be good to go.
I'm glad that you're healthy. That sounds scary.
No, very much so.
Yeah. So Anthony Weaver comes over from the Ravens. What do you know about the Ravens style defense, particularly as it relates to the linebacker position, and how do you think that aligns with your strengths?
Yeah, very aggressive, very downhill. They obviously playing against them the last 3 years. Trying to go against that defense was, almost impossible at times. But again, just the linebacker play, again, just downhill physical football. And then being able to, you protect the second level, protect the middle of the field. I think that's something that they did really well in Baltimore, and that's something that I pride myself on. You know, protecting the middle of the field, make sure that, you know, if the team wants to attack the middle, that they pay for it every time. You know, whether that's run game or pass game. And then when you have elite corners, elite DBs, and an elite pass rush, you know, obviously, which Miami does, it makes it a lot easier on the linebackers. So I think if you watch the Ravens, you know, their linebackers are downhill flying, blitzing, and everything like that, but they also control the middle of the field in the passing game. And that's kind of, you know, you put it all together, that's how it should look.
Thanks, Anthony.
Mm-hmm. Adam?
Hey, Anthony. Adam Beasley, the Pro Football Network. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
So, Kader Kuhu's wearing number 4. Jalen Ramsey's wearing number 5. Where does that leave you?
That's a great question. Something that I've been dealing with since I signed with the Dolphins. So we'll take care of it when the time comes. But I made a joke. One of my friends. He's like, I was like, I'm gonna ask Jalen Ramsey for number 5, and he was like, he gonna give you a high five. those guys, man. You talk about, you know, two of the premier defensive backs in the NFL. Those two right there. So, you know, kind of out of the question with those two, but you know, we'll see where what number I'm able to get. I would love to stay in the single digits. You know, that's kind of become my forte since they allow that for linebackers. But if I have to get another number, it's not a big deal. I'll make the best of it.
I asked you kind of jokingly, but there is, you know, it's to a broader point, there is a lot of talent on this defense.
No doubt. Exactly.
Can you give me your kind of like your scouting report of the Miami Dolphins defense with all the pieces you have now?
Yeah, I think they rush the passer really well. You got two elite edge rushers. Obviously, you lose Big Wilk in the middle. But again, a lot of talent up front, a lot of talent in the defensive back room. Linebacker room loaded as well. You know, David Long, one of my guys, I've known him for a very long time now, playing against him, you know, he played in Tennessee and I played for Indy. So growing a relationship with him over the years, I know he is excited, you know, for, you know, again, just another opportunity to go out there and play. Jordan Brooks, another, you know, key addition. Been watching him for years at Seattle. Always, you know, play really well, good linebacker football. So I think the team itself is loaded with talent, but that only goes so far. You know, I think I've been a part of some talented teams in Cleveland and Indy, and, you know, we just haven't been able to pull it all together. So, you know, I think that's the tell of football, right? Can you put it all together no matter, you know, all the talent in the world, but can you just put it all together? And I think that's the challenge that we have to embrace and take on, and I think we can do that here.
Thanks for your time, man.
Appreciate you.
Hal?
Hi, Anthony. It's Hal Habit from the Palm Beach Post. Look forward to meeting you in person, but good to meet you virtually.
Nice to meet you as well.
I wanted to follow up a little bit on what Adam was just asking you about regarding the number 4 jersey in Cleveland. I heard that you didn't even ask for anything in return, and yet you were still handed a Rolex. Tell me how that went down, and how's the Rolex treating you?
The Rolex is treating me really nice, but honestly, again, franchise quarterback, you know, highest paid player in the NFL at that time. You know, why would I even try to, you know, make it hard on him? You know, so I saw we got that done. And I literally text head coach, equipment, and Deshaun in the group chat. I was like, hey, man, you got number 4. I'll figure it out. That's really how I went. I knew, you know, obviously, you know, I wanted him to feel as comfortable and welcome as possible. I know he's worn that jersey pretty much all his life. So, you know, it was a no-brainer for real for me. Was able to, you know, get number 5, a number that I had worn before as well. So, you know, it was all good. And then one day I was literally doing a press conference after OTA practice. And he handed me a Rolex, which I thought was pretty dope, and it was pretty cool. On top of, you know, donating money to my dad's football team, my senior year with Pace High School, and actually pay for my soups that year during the season. So, great teammate, you know, nothing but all love for him, and I'm very appreciative of that.
Great. Thank you.
Mm-hmm, no problem.
David?
Anthony, you touched on it a little bit, but want to get your thoughts more on the other linebackers there. David Long joining him and Jordan Brooks coming aboard with you as well.
Yeah, no, again, two elite linebackers that's been playing at an elite level for a very long time. You know, it'll be good to compete with those guys and, you know, see what we can bring to this team. You know, obviously David Long been here, played really well, you know, obviously watching him all last year. Again, Jordan Brooks, you know, everything that he brings from Seattle, great coverage ability, able to blitz, stop the run, everything like that. So I think we have a really good group that is it's only going to push each other to be better. And, you know, it'd be fun to compete with those guys.
Okay, we have two more questions. We'll go to Mark and then Hal to close us off.
Hey, just to touch on, you said your dad was the head coach at Monsignor Pace.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
I'm just curious, when you were playing in high school, were there any local players that made it to the NFL that you looked up to or had contact with that helped push you to get where you are today?
Yeah, that's a great question, by the way. You know, obviously it's a lot of talent in South Florida. You know, you think about guys that come way before me that I watched and grew up watching, and you know, me and my dad's favorite thing to do was go to high school games and college games and, you know, watch the University of Miami, watch, you know, Miami Northwestern, high school, go play and play football and play at an elite level. So I can give you three guys off the top right now. Sean Spence played at the University of Miami, played at Miami Northwestern, played in the league. Levante David was also on that state championship, national championship team with Sean Spence in high school. So those two right there, pretty close to, you know, very close to those guys as far as those guys being my mentors. But, you know, we're like best friends now. You know, we literally talk every day. So I talk to both of those guys every day, watch film with those guys all the time. So, you know, those are two. And then obviously you got to, you know, you got to throw in Teddy Bridgewater and what he means to the Miami community and all that he's done. And, you know, again, for someone for me to look up to, you know, since I was a kid, you know, to see him play at Busch Park and then Miami Northwestern and go to Louisville and, you know, all the stuff that he does in the community, just something to look up to, someone to look up to and that does everything the right way and in a positive manner.
And if I can follow up real quick, Larry Little went to Booker T. He's a Dolphin alum and he won a Super Bowl. So what would it mean to you to win a Super Bowl for your hometown team?
Yeah, obviously you play this game, you know, and, you know, it's a blessing to play this game and you're able to do so many things with it if you do it the right way and, you know, come in contact with a lot of people. But at the end of the day, we play this game to win, you know, and I'm not saying that as a cliche. We play to win the game, like for real, we really do. But you play to win the Super Bowl, and that is something that I've always wanted to accomplish, you know, and for me to, you know, for it to happen, you know, with me playing in my hometown would be pretty special. It'd be great to be a part of, knowing that, you know, this organization, you know, has done it before and they, you know, want to get back to those winning ways. And, you know, to be a small part of that would be great.
Final question, Hal.
Hi, I wanted to follow up if I could a little bit. You mentioned earlier the low-grade infection that you had. Mm-hmm. Was there ever a point before they decided that it was low grade where it was a concern for you? Were you hospitalized or anything like that?
Yeah, I was. I was hospitalized for a good while, and I had no idea. I didn't know what it was. I thought, I mean, you know, you think the worst, right? You know, you think like, man, will I be able to play the game again? You know, to the worst, even worse than that. So, you know, my dad was there with me the whole time. I really appreciate him for that. The team, my teammates, my coaches, and everybody kept me in high spirits. The doctors were great and everything like that. So I am very fortunate that it was only a low grade infection. And, you know, I can continue playing football. But yeah, definitely scary moments for sure.
How long did that period last where you were kind of in the dark?
Yeah, about 6 weeks.
Oh.
Yeah, about 6 weeks. You know, like I said, I didn't play the Chicago game and, you know, I had to miss the rest of the season. And then, you know, 2 weeks after that was still there, you know, going through that period. So, you know, there was a long shot that I would play if we made the Super Bowl in Cleveland. But, you know, that was the best case scenario. So, but we're good now, here now. Looking forward to the opportunity to play in Miami and go out and compete with my teammates.